In this lesson, we will discuss the basic concepts of creating and working with lists in Dynamo. In Dynamo, we can have lists that contain data of varying lengths and depths. By the end of this lesson, you will have an understanding of list structure in Dynamo. You will know how to create a list of points, and you'll have an understanding of what lacing is. In Dynamo, I am currently running in automatic run mode. As a reminder, your run mode is indicated in the bottom left-hand corner of your screen and is changeable by selecting the drop-down. For this example, we want to run in automatic run mode because we want to see the changes happen live as we make them. To get started, we will locate a node called Sequence. This node is located under List, Generate, Sequence. Go ahead and place it now. The sequence node allows us to create a sequence of numbers with a given start, amount, and step. Notice the blue line next to the input ports. This indicates that the node has default values and will generate results right away. In this case, the node is outputting 0 through 9 by default. We can hover and pin the output preview to see the results. In order to fulfill these inputs with our own values, we will use number nodes. Let's go ahead and right-click in the canvas and search for the node number. We'll place it now. We need three of these nodes, so we'll go ahead and use a control copy to copy it twice more. Hold down control on your keyboard, drag the node twice. Now we have three number nodes. For the start value, we'll leave it at 0 and we'll plug that in. For the amount, let's change that to 20. We'll plug that into amount. And for the step, we'll use a 5. And we'll plug that in now. As you can see, our output now has 20 numbers, starting at 0 and counting up by 5. Let's go ahead and make this a little more dynamic. We'll change the step amount to a different node. Go ahead and delete this last number node, and we'll search for a new node to make this a little more interesting. We're going to use a number slider. So we can go ahead and search for number slider by right-clicking in the search and typing number slider. We'll go ahead and place this node now. With the number slider placed, we can fulfill the step input with this output. At this point, it doesn't look like it's updated, but as you change the slider values, the output will update accordingly. With the number slider node, we are able to modify the values quite a bit. Within the node, you can select the dropdown and change the values. For this example, we'll go ahead and leave them as they are by default, but they're always here for you to change as you would like. In order to visualize the results of these nodes, we will use points. In order to create points based on this data, we're going to use a node called PointByCoordinates. We can locate this node in the library under Geometry, Points, Point. We're going to use the XYZ option for now. To fulfill this node, we'll drag it over to the right, and we'll connect the output of the sequence node to the X and Y input ports. Keep in mind, with the Dynamo geometry preview, we may not be able to fully see the results. In order to make this more clear, we can enable the background preview by clicking on the background preview icon and clicking the zoom to fit icon. Also, remember that right-clicking and dragging will allow you to explore the geometry preview. We'll toggle back to the canvas view, and at this point, you should have an angled list of points. As we modify the slider, the points will get closer or further from one another. Next, we will modify the point by coordinates node to create a grid of points. But before we do that, we want to explore a concept called lacing. In Dynamo, lacing is the process at which a node runs with multiple sequences of data. To better illustrate this, I'm going to save this file and open another file in the dataset titled lacing. This portion is primarily to demonstrate lacing, so there is no direct need to follow along. Of course, you could follow along if you'd like, since the file is in the dataset. It's entirely up to you. The sample file, titled lacing, creates two sets of points. One set is shorter than the other. At the end of the graph, we're creating a line with two points. By default, nodes will run in automatic lacing, which works in most cases. Auto lacing solves for the node based on the input values. The lacing setting appears in the bottom right-hand corner of the node. If we select the ellipses button, we can modify the lacing. So let's go ahead and select the one on the line by start point endpoint node, navigate to lacing, and we'll change this to shortest. Shortest lacing results in the same condition as auto. This tells us that auto was utilizing shortest lacing in this case. Next, I will toggle to longest lacing. So the ellipses button, lacing, longest. Notice that with longest lacing, the last point of the first list of points will tie into the rest of the second set of points. This is taking the longest of the two lists combined with the last item of the first list to generate the result. Finally, we will try another option called cross product. We'll navigate to the ellipses, lacing, cross product. Cross product is interesting because it will give us all available iterations of this node. This one resulted in a more weaving effect. With lacing covered, we'll go ahead and open our original file once again. At this point, we can go ahead and modify the lacing of our point by coordinates node. For our point by coordinates node, we will notice that auto, shortest, and longest result in the same output. This is because the lists are identical. It really gets interesting when we change the lacing to cross product. Let's do that now. Click the ellipses button, navigate to lacing, cross product. With cross product selected, we have a grid of points. This is because Dynamo is now giving us every permutation of the inputs. This also gives us a list of lists as rows and columns of points. With that change made, this lesson is complete and we will save our Dynamo graph. To recap, in this lesson we learned how to construct sequences of data and we learned about lacing. In the next lesson, we will learn how to modify this output and access pieces of data within this list.